guys, today we are going to learn about the working principle of transformer. So, transformer works on the principle of Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So, what is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction? Whenever conductor cuts the flux or flux links with the conductor, an EMF will be induced in it. Okay, so what are the basic requirements to induce the EMF? So to induce the EMF, the basic requirements are conductor and flux. What are the basic requirements? Conductor and flux. In general, we will represent the flux with a letter phi. These two are the basic requirements. See, let us say this is the conductor and this one is the flux. Okay, simply by keeping the conductor aside and flux aside, we cannot induce the EMF. Here, our main aim is to induce the EMF. Okay, so there must be a relative space variation or relative time variation. Relative space variation relative time variation. So these two are the techniques which we'll use to induce the EMF. Okay, in case of relative space variation, conductor is rotating one and flux is static. Flux is static. But whereas in case of transformer, conductors are stationary. All the conductors are stationary in case of and flux is variable one means it will varies with respect to time. Okay, so as a whole, in case of transformer we will use relative time variation technique. Okay, so relative time variation means conductors are stationary and flux is constant. Conductors stationary and flux varies with respect to time. So flux varying with respect to time means here the flux is alternating nature of flux. Okay, so alternating nature of flux in the sense flux varies with respect to time like this. Okay, whenever this flux links with the stationary conductor, EMF will be induced in the transformer. Okay, so in case of transformer, the EMF induced is statically induced EMF. Okay, so how much is the magnitude of flux produced? So the magnitude of statically induced EMF can be determined by Faraday's second law. So what is Faraday's second law? According to Faraday's second law, EMF induced is directly proportional to rate of change of flux linkages. That is represented like this. E is equal to minus N into d phi by dt. Here, phi is the flux, which is given by flux is equal to MMF by reluctance. What is MMF? MMF is nothing but magnetomotive force. In case of circuits, that is in case of AC circuits, use a word EMF. EMF. Similarly, in case of magnetic circuits, that is MMF, magnetomotive force. So, magnetomotive force in the sense, work done in moving unit magnetic pole or unit flux, unit magnetic pole around magnetic circuit. Okay, that is MMF. Okay, simply work done in moving a unit Weber in a magnetic circuit. So, reluctance. In general, in case of electrical circuits, we use it to deal with resistance. Resistance in the sense, the property of material which opposes the flow of current. Here, reluctance is the property of material which opposes flow of flux. That is, opposition. This is opposition offered by magnetic circuit. Okay, and here N is the number of turns in the winding. Okay, if you consider, this is the magnetic core of the transformer. Primary winding is having some number of turns and secondary winding is having some number of turns. Okay, where N is the number of turns. So, what about this negative sign? This negative sign is placed according to Lenz's law. Simply, what is Lenz's law? Lenz's law means, simply, easily we can say, opposing the cause. See, let us say, due to production of EMF, let us say this is a coil. So, due to the production of EMF in the coil, some amount of flux is producing. Okay? Let us say phi s is the flux producing. Due to this flux, what happens is, some amount of current will flow through the circuit. Okay? Due to this current, some other flux will produce like this. This flux opposes the main field flux. Okay? Main field flux. See, here, let us consider phi p is the parent flux. Okay? So, due to this flux, children flux was produced. Let us say phi c. C is the children flux. This is the parent flux. Now, what the thing was happening is, this children flux opposing the parent flux. Okay? So, this opposition is represented by negative symbol here. Okay? So, this is about Lenz's law. Okay? These are the basic laws which we are using to explain the working principle of transformer. Okay? So, this is about the working principle of transformer. Thank you.